So, guys, there is a petition that is doing the rounds on the internet. This is about the new brilliant ANC mayor of Johannesburg, Dada Mrego. And this petition calls for the removal of the mayor after the mayor has suggested that the city should hire documented foreign nationals into JNPD to help deal with crime. So, according to the mayor, there are a lot of challenges when it comes to language barrier. Some of these criminals that are operating in Johannesburg, the language they speak, the officials in JNPD cannot even understand. So this is the only solution that the mayor could come up with. And of course, South Africans are outraged. The whole country is outraged because this is a short-sighted solution. You can see that on the petition here, already there are already over 4,000 signatures that were collected. And this article actually came out yesterday, 17 hours ago, and there are already over 4,000 signatures that have been collected. South Africans are saying it is enough. We have actually seen enough of the new mayor of Johannesburg. So there are four points that this petition is making, and I think this is the reason why this petition is quite popular as we speak. So let's see what the petition actually says. So number one, they are talking about the disregard for the rule of law. The petition says the mayor has faced criticism for his proposals to hire foreign nationals into Johannesburg Metropolis Department, a move that is allegedly contradicts both South African Constitution and the immigration laws. This is point number one, disregard for the rule of law. The petition says that this suggestion of yours actually goes against the South African Constitution and the immigration laws. So point number two, they are talking about lack of accountability. The mayor has been quoted stating that citizens should not expect too much from him, a statement perceived as a failure to commit to his public duties. You remember, guys, I think it was like 7 days ago when the new mayor of Johannesburg made this outrageous statement that South Africans should not expect any big improvements while he's in charge. So I think if we lived in a sane country, this statement was supposed to be enough to actually say, no, this guy is not the one for the job. After Dada said the citizens should not expect any big improvements from him, the ANC was supposed to call him right there and there. But the ANC still allowed him to continue to be the mayor of Johannesburg. So I think it says everything that we need to know about the ANC. Point number three that the petition is making, they are talking about infrastructure mismanagement. The mayor's response to the gas explosion at the Brie taxi rank has also came under fire. Instead of prioritizing road repairs, he has proposed converting the area into a park, which many view as impractical and misguided. So, as we speak, the mayor has said three things. He has suggested for the city to hire documented foreign nationals into JNPD to help deal with crime. The mayor has already told the South Africans that, guys, please do not expect any big improvements coming from me. Don't expect anything from me. And number three, the mayor has proposed converting the area that was blown up by that gas explosion to be converted into a park. Number four, the petition talks about inaction on hijacked buildings. The mayor's administration has been criticized for failing to implement an effective plan to deal with the issue of hijacked buildings, a problem that continues to endanger both residents and business owners in South Africa. Guys, I think we have said enough about hijacked buildings and the fact that there is no political will from the ANC to deal with this issue of hijacked buildings. You remember last time when that building caught fire in Johannesburg, where 80 people lost their lives. The ANC Minister of Social Development, Lindiwe Zulu, went there and said that this is not the problem of these people that are living here illegally. This is not the problem of these people that have hijacked this building. This is a problem of apartheid. We are blaming apartheid for this thing. So I think right now we know as a country that there is no political will inside the African National Congress to actually deal with the issue of hijacked buildings. They are fine with the fact that there are thousands and thousands of hijacked buildings in Johannesburg. You remember last time Herman Mashaba was talking about this? Herman Mashaba actually said that there are 6,000 hijacked buildings in Johannesburg, and the ANC government hasn't been able to do anything about that. So there is no political will from the ANC to do anything about those hijacked buildings. So guys, this is the new brilliant ANC mayor of Johannesburg, Dada Morero, telling South Africans that we should hire foreign nationals. You know, this statement, I think South Africans took it as a slap and a spit in the face. When you think about how many people are sitting at home unemployed, and the fact that this person is going to be the mayor of a huge city in the country, and these are kind of solutions that he comes up with, I think this statement by itself already proven to the whole country what kind of a person and what kind of a mayor this person is going to be. He is short-sighted. He doesn't think things through. Him and his administration are not serious about serving the people of Johannesburg, and they are not serious about saving the people of this country. This is a statement that actually landed him into fire.
Comrade Chair, Deputy Chair, I always ask this question, that none of our police men and women in uniform can speak any of the foreign African languages. And the challenge is for us to deal with crime.
I mean, the mayor says that the officials in JMPD, they cannot speak the African languages. So the first thing that actually comes to my mind when he says that is, what have you people been doing all along? What have you been doing all along? In Johannesburg, what has the ANC been doing all along? You look at cities like Johannesburg, Durban, and Cape Town. This is not supposed to be a problem, because these people are dealing with the criminals that are coming from all over the world. So the governments in these cities, they are supposed to have people who can actually understand the language that these people are speaking. The fact that today we are talking about the criminals that are speaking the language that the officials cannot understand, it means that these people were not doing anything about this problem that has been there. But according to me, this was not even supposed to be a problem. This is something that should have been dealt with 20 years ago. It should have been dealt with 20 years ago. But we are here today, and the ANC mayor tells us that we should hire the foreign nationals who come from the same place as these criminals.
Comrade Chair, Deputy Chair, I always ask this question, that none of our police men and women in uniform can speak any of the foreign African languages. And the challenge is for us to deal with crime. And you can have all your suspects here. Before they write their statements, they can plan what they are going to say in front of you without you even hearing what they are saying. It might be a culture shock to suggest to this REC that if we are serious about fighting crime in Ward 67, we have no option but those that are properly documented with proper documents can be recruited to the Johannesburg Metro Police Department.
I mean, like, this statement doesn't make sense, man. This statement doesn't make sense. I mean, like, those people, like, they can collude. They can collude with those documented foreign nationals in front of you. They can still collude. So the only solution to actually deal with this thing is to make sure that, okay, let's empower South Africans. Let's empower South Africans to actually understand these languages. I mean, like, the fact that this is a problem today, I don't understand how is this a problem today. I don't.
The priority is to perhaps sort out crime, because Johannesburg is the most dangerous city in South Africa. So are you trying to say that perhaps documented foreign nationals should be hired because of the language barrier that police officers and JMPD face when they arrest undocumented persons or those committing crimes from other African countries? Was that the thought process?
The thought in the statement would have meant that, but unfortunately the discussions that we have entered in felt that at the current state in which you'd know we're experiencing high levels of unemployment and so on and so on, the view was that let's find other alternative methods to help us address the language barrier, which may mean taking officers for training. It may mean that at certain instances, as the courts already do, have interpreters to help us to deal with some of the matters. You know, in the courts, a case can prolong because we still have to go through a process of procuring somebody who understands French or any other language, whether it's Ndebele or Shona, which cannot be understood by South African courts, and they will then procure. So the similar process that Lekgotla would have said, perhaps let's look at those as options, as opposed to probably having a few in the system who are able to speak those languages.
So was that decision parked? That's not something that you've adopted or said, okay, let's look into this. You've decided to say, actually, South Africans being hired are the priority.
No, that's what the Lekgotla said, and the Lekgotla is specific, and we are not thinking two ways for now.
But why would you make that suggestion, Mr. Moreira, in the first place?
Well, I think perhaps I should have made the suggestion in a normal environment or in an emerald society. And it is informed about the development of other cities in the world, whether it's New York or metropolitan cities in the world where they have this inclusion, so that it helps them to effectively deal with crime and criminals.
So the new mayor has actually came to his senses. He has actually came to his senses, and now he's apologizing to South Africans and saying that, guys, I'm sorry, man, I'm sorry. This goes against the ANC. This goes against South Africa. And we know that many people are actually unemployed into the country. And for me to actually suggest something like this, of course, it was going to make people feel sad, and it was going to make people angry. So the mayor has walked back. He suggested to actually hire foreign nationals into JMPD to help deal with the issue of language barrier. So I think that question that lady asked in that interview, it was like, it is important. How can you even suggest something like this? Because when you say that this is not something that the ANC agrees with, we can actually understand by that statement alone that you don't even understand what the ANC wants. You don't understand what the ANC wants. You don't understand what the ANC stands for.
Including the challenges on migration and in migration. The Lekgotla resolved that we should instead train our officers to be proficient in foreign languages that are dominant in areas with the highest concentration of specific groups of foreign nationals.
Of course. This is the reason why people were so angry when they heard you saying that we need to hire the foreign nationals into JMPD to deal with crime, because the problem is language barrier. I mean, like, it's easy, it's there, it's right in your face. Train the people that you have. Train the people that you have so that they can understand these languages. You don't have to come out to propose something like this in a country that is ravished with unemployment rate. You don't have to do that. You really don't have to. The solution was there, right in front of your face, but you couldn't wait to go out and tell South Africans that we have to deal with crime. We have to deal with crime, and for us to deal with crime, we have to hire the documented foreign nationals, the people that understand the language that has been spoken by these criminals that you are talking about. I mean, of course, empower the people. Empower South Africans to understand the language that these criminals are speaking, so that you can hire South Africans, so that South Africans can get into the employment line. It's outrageous, man. It's outrageous. The whole mayor of Johannesburg. You know, guys, I know that people are talking about Dada Morero and the fact that he has come back from his initial statement. But I honestly believe that this goes straight into his judgment as the mayor of the city. It goes straight into his judgment as the mayor of the city. It tells us about the kind of person he is, the kind of person and the kind of decisions that he's going to make. It tells us everything that we need to know. I am not surprised that petitions are coming out swinging to say that this person should not be the mayor of Johannesburg. I understand why people say we have seen enough of this person and we don't want this person as the mayor of Johannesburg. It says everything. It says everything about his judgment. It says everything about his judgment. It is not only about the fact that this guy has come out to suggest that the city should hire documented foreign nationals. No, it is not only about that. It is about the judgment, the kind of person you are, and the decisions that you are going to make. If you live in Johannesburg, you should be worried that this is the person that is going to make decisions about your life. You should be worried. I would be very worried, man, if I lived in Johannesburg, knowing very well that we just got rid of that Gwamanda guy from Al Jamaa. Now we have Dada Morero from the ANC. Now we have Dada Morero from the ANC. How is this guy different from Gwamanda, who has just left office? How are they different? How are they different? You can see that, like, this guy oozes of incompetence. He oozes of incompetence. And Johannesburg is not going to be fixed. If the people think that Johannesburg is good, all of those problems that are facing Johannesburg are going to be dealt with, the problems that are facing Johannesburg, they are not going to be dealt with. They are not going to be dealt with. This is the person that the ANC thinks this is the person that the ANC thinks that he deserves to be the mayor of Johannesburg. So if you live in Johannesburg, this is what the ANC wants you to lead. This is the kind of person that the ANC thinks is best to lead your city. You should be very worried if you live in Johannesburg. You should be very worried. You should be very worried. Because I think sometimes we look at the issues and we are just criticizing people about the issues, but instead of just looking at their judgment, instead of looking at the bigger picture, man, this guy is going to sit in the office of the mayor of Johannesburg. Can you just imagine the solutions that he's going to come up with? You remember that road that was blown up in Bree Street? The same person comes out and says that no, that place should be converted into a park. It should be converted into a park. And he also comes out and says that no, do not expect anything from me. He also comes out and says that no, we should hire the documented foreign nationals to help us deal with the issue of crime, because there are a lot of problems when it comes to language barrier. You should be worried as a citizen of Johannesburg. You should be worried. You should be worried that this is the person that has all the power. This is the person that is going to be making all the decisions. You should be worried. Man, look at how disappointed these people are. Man, look at his face and look at this person's face. The fact that you have to sit there with this person apologizing to South Africans for saying something so ridiculous. Look at the facial expressions of these two people. They are not happy to be sitting next to that mayor. They are not happy.
Including the challenges on migration and in-migration. The Lekgotla resolved that we should instead train our officers to be proficient in foreign languages that are dominant in areas with the highest concentration of specific groups of foreign nationals. The Lekgotla, however, accepted the concern that language barriers frustrate police work as valid and legitimate. Upon further reflection, I have come to the conclusion that my suggestion was not consistent with the...
No, stop lying, man. You did not come to the conclusion. People were outraged. You were pushed by people's outrage. This is the reason why you are sitting there and apologize. It is not you thinking that, okay, I have made a terrible statement. Let me go out and rectify it. You are only making this statement because South Africans are actually outraged with you suggesting that. So don't make it look like this is your own thing, like this is mine. I had to sit down alone by myself and actually think about these statements that I'm making in public. And maybe I need to go out and start apologizing to South Africans. No, do not make it look like you are the ones that are making those. You are the one that is actually thinking about this thing. People's outrage is the one that actually pushed you to sit there and apologize and walk back on everything that you have said.
The policies of the ANC and policies of government and legitimate. Upon further reflection, I have come to the conclusion that my suggestion was not consistent with the policies of the ANC and policies of government.
So how can you go out and make a public statement? How can you go out and make a public statement when this statement of yours is not consistent with the ANC, is not consistent with the government? So how can you go out and make that kind of a statement? How can you go out, man?
I have come to the conclusion that my suggestion was not consistent with the policies of the ANC and policies of government. I therefore unconditionally withdraw my proposal and apologize for the anxiety it might have caused to the residents of Johannesburg and the people of South Africa as a whole. I wish to appreciate, of course, the robust manner in which our people were engaged in this discourse, especially in social media platforms. The participation of our people in this discourse reaffirms our belief that we have a vibrant and conscious citizenry upon which a prosperous society can and will be built. And let me conclude by saying...
Let me conclude by saying that I'm sorry. But guys, like, honestly, if you are a citizen of Johannesburg, you should be very worried about the fact that this guy is going to be your mayor. You should be worried, man. You should be worried, man. I would be worried as hell, knowing very well that Dada is going to be... Dada is my mayor, man. I would be so worried. I would be so worried. The red flags about Dada Morero are all over the place. The red flags about this guy are all over the place. And for him to continue to be the mayor of Johannesburg, man, that would be a disservice by the ANC to the people of Johannesburg. It will be a huge disservice by the ANC to the people of Johannesburg. Like I said earlier on, when Dada Morero said that, do not expect anything from me, do not expect much, because there are not going to be big improvements as long as I'm in charge, that was supposed to be enough for the ANC to say, you are not the man for the job. Johannesburg is a big city that is in a lot of trouble. We need someone who is going to work to make sure that that city actually works. And you come out and tell the citizens of this country to not expect anything from you. You are not the man for the job. That's why I said that if we lived in a sane country, the ANC was never going to make this person the mayor of Johannesburg. But unfortunately, we live in an insane country, and this person is the mayor of Johannesburg. So I guess the only thing that I can say to the people of Johannesburg is to say good luck, guys. Good luck. Even here in the Free State where I live, we have the mayor of the ANC, man. And you know how things are. When your city is presided over by the ANC, you know how it goes. You know how it goes. Guys, please tell me what you think in the comment section. Don't forget to hit that like button. And the most important part, subscribe. My name is Thomas Mabaso. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.